Anything else? Yes. Yes. See, you there can be two approach. You can make a separate notes, or if you have a note, make a sticky notes, staple there, write inside, however you want to do it. But that can include example, that can include data, that can include case history, that can include diagrams, flow chart, that can include high court, supreme court judgment, those things that it can include. Earlier I did Ashutosh Pandey sir, this time I did Lukman sir. Whatever you are joining, be serious and be, if it is taking sectional test, prepare your, make framework of all the previous year question. Go through other questions that are available on Insight or India or whatever resources you are using. And then go there in examination. Test series you need to take very seriously. And don't be like that, I will write afterwards, I will write when I will read. You will never read, it will never be completed, you will never feel confident. You need to one day sit down and start writing answer. And that's the only thing that is going to pay you back. Whether it is GS, whether it is ASA, whether it is ethics, PABAD, anything. Only writing, and writing will pay you. And adding value to your answer, adding conceptual clarity, trying to understand the demand of the public ad. Only public ad is, there is a specific point that you need to understand the question also. Other than in GS, you need to keep writing again and again. If you are not able to write, just think about the framework, because you need to have mental clarity, what all I will touch, and then you will be able to write a good answer. And if you have a specific problem, like you are not able to write fast, or you are not able to write in clearly, try to improve on that, write in short sentences, write short sentences, write simple words, that will help in improving that. And speed is all about practice. If you improve more, practice more, speed will increase. Even then, if you are not able to, don't write too much answer. Write point wise, write diagram, use help, take help of example. For example, I used to do like just make role of PMO. That way it improves the visibility also. It takes less time, it takes less words, and you are able to communicate. If there is a question on, for example, e-governance, write like this. Yes. But it should be relevant. Answer, whole answer in flowchart. Yeah, some information if you want to add. Yes, you can do that. And moreover, I used to do that, because often if you are writing only in points, if you are writing only in paragraph, it becomes monotonous. Moreover, it might give a message that you have went to some coaching institute and they have tutored you, they have prepared you. So if you are using variation, it gives a different flavor. And a person who is checking your answer is mostly above 55, 60, and he had a huge lunch, he might be sleepy. So you need to make sure that your answer is interesting, your answer is more visible. So these things help in improving the visibility and saving on time, saving on words. So few answers. What I used to follow, if I have good amount of knowledge, content, I will write in points so that I cover everything. If I have only 2-3 points, I will write only in paragraph. Public policy, Mohit Bhattacharya, Vagiram notes, sir notes, ARC also you can, and then think about, read about two, three policies, midday meal details, midday meal or whatever policy you want, how it is implemented, and then relate, oh, this is this policy implementation, this is review, who is reviewing it, and social audit examples you can get, everything you can get and incorporate on that. And add diagram policy, that diagram everybody knows, so those things you can add. Other than that, if you want, you can go through IGNU, but it is very big booklet. If you are not able to read few pages, try to find out few examples and flip it and find any diagram if it is there. Copy it, use that in diagram.
Sir,
you need to balance how much time you want to put in for only for public policy. Yes. Yes. If it is relevant to your answer, then you quote. If it is directly linked, you write that. I am not able to understand your question. That is again based on your understanding and your analyzing capacity and your language also, how you are trying to link it. If there is a linkage, you will be able to know. Then write it. Obviously. It depends on interpretation also, na? If he has said any statement and something happened and it is directly linkable, then you can link it. Have confidence in your understanding. If you think it is linked, write it. Then it is linked. Yeah, obviously. If you think it is linked, write it. But write clearly. In case studies also, when you are writing, write clearly. Don't become ambiguous. Like he is not able to understand what point you are trying to make. So it should be very clear what point you are trying to make, and how you are justifying your point. Okay. Yes. If your diagram needs explanation, don't make it. It should be very clear, because if you are making diagram and then explaining it, it is not a diagram. That's why when you are making diagram in your notes, make simple diagram. Don't use complicated diagram. If it is simple, easy to remember, then only make it. Otherwise, you will forget. And this is one of the best things. Make cycle and run it. I think more than in 50% of questions I have made diagram. But most of them will be like this. If a question is on PMO and Cabinet Secretariat, role of PMO, role of Cabinet Secretariat, because I do not need to touch upon that. And then I will write whatever points I have to make. See, I have a very fast writing speed. No. If this is a question and you are writing 3 points, this side, 3 points, that side, and giving a good conclusion, even in you can write that answer. And if you have only 3 minutes left, CAG as appendix to pack, 2 points, CAG as independent, 2 points, write conclusion. In 3 minutes you can write that answer. Yes. See, that is a very difficult thing, because I did go through some of the journals, but again it becomes a fruitless thing if you are not able to reproduce that. You can go through some journals, but you need to be careful, you need to balance how much time you want to devote. That American Society for Public Administration, IIPA, is also there. Read the topic. If it is very relevant, then only read it. Otherwise, but don't get into the habit of covering everything. That is not going to. It is again very lucky thing. You will read some article, you will understand that article, then that article will come. So if you are reading it and you are able to understand, read it and take few points, whether it is for understanding, whether it is for example, whatever, if you are able to understand, read that and just leave it alone. Write 2-3 points in your notes and leave it alone. For example, I went through some of the articles like Science of Muddling Through, and then Wilson paper, public policy, the original articles. NPS, there was a book on Denhard and Denhard. I went through some of the portion of it. But I do not suggest that because it is a very long-term thing. And it depends on how much time you have, how much you want to devote on PubMed. So those factors you need to take, and based on your strategy should be based on your strengths and weaknesses. Anything else on PubMed? Coming the? So you go through summary. See, for example, disaster management. You know everything about disaster management. Okay. Every day, every now and then there is some disaster and there is some example from there. CAG will come up with a study and it will show what the shortcomings in Uttarakhand. Write that point. Then you do not need to go through disaster management. If you are able to go through summary, then that will also help. So it depends on how much time you have, how important that topic is, because in disaster management there will be one or two question maximum, and it will not be based on very conceptual clarity. It will be simple question that you need, that you can write from newspaper reading also. Summary. There are summary from all the coaching institutes, right? You can take any one of them. There was a very, I had a very in summary from 2012, so I used to go through that. How, okay. If you are linking with paper 1 of PubMed, it is a PubMed question. If you are linking with political science thinkers, it is political science question. If you are not linking, it is GS answer. Then it will. Then you may get less marks if you are not linking with PubMed 1 and it is linkable. If you are not linking it, then it is showing that you do not have the correct understanding. That's where these things will help you. If you are, whenever you are reading, for example, you are reading Prasad and Prasad, you are reading about some thinker and he has said something. Think about it, how you can use in Indian administration. Then only you will be able to, your understanding will improve, then only you will be able to link that information. Otherwise, you will not do. There is no, I cannot prepare a notes and give it to you. That will be fruitless because you need to reproduce it. So for that, you need to prepare on your own, you need to think on your own, analyze on your own. Use that again and again, revise that, use in your answer writing, then only you will be able to. Did I answer your question? I got 142 in paper 1 and 125 in paper 2. Yes, GS paper I will talk. Anything else provide? See, one more thing I need to tell. Many a times we ignore paper 2 and keep our focus on paper 1 only. Thinker, 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 NPA, NPM, NPA, NPM. You need to focus on all the areas, especially paper 2 and also on second part of paper 1. CAG, CPA, DA, public policy, those are also important. So distribute your time in such a fashion. It is important to have better understanding in thinkers and evolution, but don't ignore the other portion. Similarly, don't ignore the static question. Write few static answer of few static question at home. Write your best answer. Try to integrate information from everywhere and be prepared for that. Because if there is only static question, you need to score well on those questions. And similarly, if you are not able to handle part 1 of paper 1, you need to write better answer in part 2 of paper 1. You can attempt 3 questions there. That way you can improve. Yes, anything else? Did I try to help you in some portion of PubMed? Okay, thank you. Do cover economic survey, and when you are reading it, try to think how you can use that in PubMed. Similarly, in GS, all the papers, how can you can use that information? Value addition I did in all papers. GS1 only in society question you can do that. If there is any article on woman or child, any news on that, you can use that information. Any policy, you can use that information. Any data, how many women are doing this, how many women are facing domestic violence, how many women are involved in higher education. That data you can use in society. Similarly, children-based questions. Similarly, all the other topics, urbanization, you can write some data that this is the caste distribution in urban area, this is the caste distribution, distribution in rural area. If there is some study, you can quote that. So that way, value addition you can do in society-based questions from newspaper. Paper 2 and paper 3 is, you all know, is only current affairs. So I used to go through newspaper, Hindu, Indian Express, and then insights on India, all the insight secure questions, then Mrunal, then IDSA, if you have heard about ICWA, then IPCS, then Mrunal, you all know, then insights, Lukman also I used to, because editorial you can refer, Vision, and then IS for sure. See, to pick one or two, because it becomes, nowadays everybody is making a website and there are information and overload. You need to pick one or two which you think is has good quality and go through that. Similarly, IDSA, ICWA, IPCS, PRS, these you need to do in limited manner. ICWA is related to IR. You know, anybody has seen ICWA? Indian Council of World Affairs. So they are not many articles, only 10-12 articles. Inside this, if you go, there is a publication, then Policy Watch, Viewpoint, three sections are there. So you can go through that articles whenever you are not feeling like studying. You can go through these articles. There will be 10-12 articles of 2-3 pages, very easy to read, and in a month. So there will be 12-15 articles in a month. You can read whenever you find time, and it will cover IR. Cover those articles which are directly related to India. If it is dealing with some other part of the world, you do not need to bother about that. Similarly, IDASA, it will cover your security. In IR, some portion of IR, some nuclear policy, all those things it will cover. These are good articles written by esteemed bureaucrats or thinkers. These are all think tanks which are helping government, so their quality and quantity is good. But there are too many articles on ITSA, so you need to be selective. For example, if you are reading about defense procurement policy and you are not able to understand, or after that you can go through defense procurement policy IDSA, search in Google and you will get 2-3 articles, read one of them, try to get few points and then just leave it. Do not spend too much time. Similarly, all security related topic IDSA, search on ITSA, you will get 2-3 articles, read one of them. It will give you good points and help you understand. IPCS is also very bulky. There are too many articles. You need to be selective based on your time, how much you want to spend. Always balance it, how much time you are spending on a topic. Balance it with how much output and you will get from that investment. Similarly, PRS will help you in paper 2, paper 3 also some portions, and PBAD also. So all these things when you are reading, if you are find anything related to PBAD, just note it down and try to use that. In addition to that, I also used to search various newspapers like Business Line or Financial Express. If there is any topic, I used to search news from that and go through that. But you need to be very selective. You do not have the liberty to spend too much time on that. Anything else you want to know on what specific you want to know on GS? Same framework if you are preparing. 2-3 lines introduction. 2-3 line conclusion. In between body, if you are writing paragraph, you can write in paragraph. Ethics I will tell. Anything else? GS 1, 2, 3? 1, so everybody knows, na? 1, one is very static, two and three is newspaper. If there is any article, editorial, understand that topic and make notes on that. Every topic you need to have. One thing I did is I made very organized notes. For example, I used one note, and if there is governance topic, in this I used to write all the news. If I am getting some notes from newspaper, I will write it here only. If I am getting any data, I will write here only. If I am getting any policy, I will write here only. So that when I am revising it, I am revising a comprehensive thing. And once I had prepared all my notes, it had all the insights question also, all the newspaper notes also. So everything at the same place. Because if you are writing in, I face that challenge. If I am writing in copy, I will write day one something here, then that information comes something else, then it does not sink into your mind, you are not able to reproduce it. So I thought that if I will do, help me, and it did help. And it gave me very, I was able to revise all my GS1-2 in 2 days, all GS3 and GS4 in 2 days. So that way every test I gave for test series, I used to revise everything and then go and write a test. That way I was able to revise 3-4 times, I was able to write answer 3-4 times, and then it helped me in final exam also. And after that, what I did, after this note preparation in November, by November 15, after November 15, I chose few of the topics which are very important, I thought will be very crucial. For example, judicial appointment, juvenile justice bill. So I prepared one page notes covering everything, short notes, and then revise that at the final moment. So that will help you in improving, covering more and more points, improving your quality. So if you are doing that 50, 60 topics for every paper, I am sure that you will get 5, 6, 7, 10 from that. And then you will be able to write a better answer in less amount of time, and you can spend the rest of the time in other questions. Okay, anything else on GS3? Economic survey. Join it if you have. I joined it, but I joined it in GS score. But my personal feedback is that review was not there. I did not find it very satisfactory. But I did write all the answers, all the tests. Initially, after getting selected also, when I last time when I went, I was able to, in first test, I was able to write only 4-5 questions. Don't get bogged down by that. Keep going every day. And if you are not writing, sit there for 3 hours. One day, next test, someday you will start writing, and that's what you need. And once you start writing, what I used to do, I had the luck to that I had a very good friend who was staying with me. So what we used to do is after writing, we used to get our test copies, photostat. He will read my answer, I will read his answer, we will discuss and add any points. That way it helped me. So I was not bothered to wait for their feedback also. If we are 2-3 people are able to review each other's answer, that will be suffice. You need to rely on your confidence, rely on your knowledge. Somebody is saying something, take it with pinch of salt. Anything else on and cover newspaper and economic survey, finance commission, books you do not need to read. If you are for prelims, you read NCERT, and I followed that Sanjeev Verma sir's book, Indian Economy. It is very 200 pages. It is very easy to read. Other than that, newspaper and Mrunal also you can cover, because for understanding purpose it is very easy. Videos are there. Just everything is free. Just utilize that information. Yes. Ethics, case study. Anything else in GS 2-3? Answer framework, you can do that in that also. GS is not about much of analysis. If you have points, you can write that. And if you are revising again, you will be able to cover more points. That's all you need. GS 4. GS4, it is very difficult to tell what to study. I went through that Chronicle book, Lexicon. After that, ARC, obviously I went through. other than that I did not read. I did not go into the theories that Kant has said this and he has said this. I did not understood it. I did not go through it. Based on your common sense, you need to write. Case study, you need to follow few structures. Write about what is the case about, what is the ethical dilemma, who are the stakeholders. Then options are given, just give the merit, demerit and give your conclusion. प्रैक्टिस करेंगे तो आएगा धीरे धीरे. और एथिकल डायलमा जो सिलेबस में दिए हैं उन्हीं में से कोई होगा. कीवर्ड के लिए सिलेबस में दी हुई है करेज वो सब और जो भी क्वालिटीज है सिविल सर्वेंट की उनकी डिफिनेशन अपने से बना के लिख लीजिए. करेज क्या होता है, इफ यू हैव टू राइट दोस थिंग्स विल नॉट बी इन फर्स्ट इट वॉज आस्क्ड बट इफ यू हैव टू राइट वॉट इज करेज यू राइट. केस स्टडी इफ यू प्रैक्टिस मोर इफ यू रीड मोर यू विल बी एबल टू हेल्प इट विल बी एबल टू हेल्प. फॉर पार्ट वन इट इज कॉमन सेंस ओनली. आई कैन नॉट टेल आई डिड नॉट डू एनीथिंग स्पेसिफिक. वन थिंग आई विल टेल अगेन दैट वैल्यू एडिशन थिंग इन GS4 व्हाट आई डिड. अगेन फ्रॉम न्यूज पेपर यू कैन पिक एग्जाम्पल्स. गो थ्रू द सिलेबस. What is there in the syllabus? What are the ethical dilemmas that can be used from newspaper? If you are able to recognize them, then you will be able to pick example from newspaper. One thing that I did. Another thing that I did was, whatever topic is given, take Gandhi. Okay, there are seven sins of Gandhi. Remember them, use them. If it is directly related, take Gandhi. Take his qualities, what he has done for social emancipation. Take a write example in your answer, in your note. Make a separate notebook for GS4. Write what Gandhi has done, B.R. Ambedkar, what he has done for removing social discrimination. Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, what he has done for child education, girl education. Raja Ram Mohan Rai, what he has done. Similarly, Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, these famous personalities, pick qualities that they have shown. T.N. Seshan, how he has shown courage. E. Sridharan, how he has shown time management, team management. Write 2-3 lines. Only all these information is already with you. You need to just write in your notebook. Don't go and read some book or something. Just think about it and how you can add them. Similarly, J.M. Lingdo or how he has shown courageous attitude or similarly 5-10 bureaucrats who are living legend. You can take them and what qualities they have shown. So all the qualities that a civil servant has, jot down these thinkers, jot down these famous personalities, what exactly they have done. 2-3 lines, that's all it takes. Similarly, Gandhi, Ambedkar, all those gender discrimination, social discrimination, religious discrimination, who has worked for that? So if you have 30-40 such things, then you can use in one of the answers in your question. That will help you. So what you need to do is prepare 15-20 page notes again for GS4, having these kind of information. What thinkers have done, similarly Western thinkers, what Aristotle has said, 2-3 quotation of these thinkers. Do not go deep into what exactly they were trying to say. If Aristotle has said that, it is the punishment for good people to be in the governance of bad people if they are not coming into politics, something like that. Write that quotation. If Ambedkar said something, write that quotation and revise it and use it in your answer. That is a value addition. There are more than 20 questions. If you are adding value and exceeding one mark, half mark here and there, then you can, because everybody is writing the same thing. If there is a quotation of Gandhi, everybody is writing the same thing. You just need to relate it to some example or some current event and use these information. If you are doing this evaluation, it will definitely help you and you will be able to fetch more marks everywhere. That's what I did. Other than that, I practiced through some of the, I wrote many tests in ethics also around 12-13, and then I practiced test case studies and these part one questions. I made framework and thought about various examples that I can write differently. See, Gandhi 7 sin, if you are remembering, one of the other places you will be able to write. Similarly, various quotations like Bible says that wisdom, patience, and what is that? Courage, wisdom, and patience. Those things you can remember and you can write. That will add value to your answer. Anything else you want to know on GS4? See, that's why you pick case studies which are very clear and making a point in a very small word. For example, that CGG, it is that CGG, Center for Good Governance, that case study is very clear. Similarly, there was a case study that PUC has done on farmer debt. So it said that in Punjab there are, the annual debt is some 2 lakh, more than 2 lakh, and annual income is 30,000. So it is showing farmer distress, it is showing debt crisis in our country, it is showing farmer suicide also, faulty agricultural prices policies also. So that thing you can integrate. It is also showing a lack of financial inclusion. So that way you can, if it is very clear, you do not need to write much. Okay, GS4 cases, okay. That is again practice. Other than that, I cannot say anything. If you are able to see, you need to understand and you need to address those demands, because last year also case studies that there are so many questions, but you need to address those questions. That is, ask, you need to address that question. No. Yes, everything. Even if you in short, you need to address everything. My GS is 405. Yes. What is? Okay. What is happiness and what gives you? Okay. See, all the keywords that are in ethics paper, if you are going through them, you understand them, and you are making a definition in your word, then you will be able to answer that. So what I will write is, what is happiness? It is, happiness is having balance between your inner and outer self, and you are able to perform more, you are able to do good to the society. If you are, there is no inner conflict, then you are in happiness. So some kind of definition in that sense you can write. And then what is your opinion? It is basically what do you think is happiness. So I will write that if I have harmony with myself and my family and my friends, and if there is harmony, if I am able to get respect, seniors, my peers, then I will be happy. So these kinds of points I can write, and add example also. For example, if I did this and that and I was able to get respect from my senior and he appreciated my work, then I was feeling happy. If I am doing what I enjoy, if I am watching some movie which I enjoy, if I am enjoying, then I am happy. If I am having harmonious relation with my family or my friends and there is no problem, so then I will be happy. Similarly, inner conflict also you need to address. If I am not having inner contradiction, not having dilemma, then I am happy. So that way you can address that question. Did I answer? So much? Yes. Yes. You need to cover, I think you need to cover more and more areas. So for example, if you are only writing one aspect and not addressing other aspects, you need to make your answer more wide, touch upon different aspects. if you are covering four five, if you are touching upon four five areas, definitely you will be having a broad based answer, and then you your marks will improve. An example, if you are supplementing your points with example, then also, and in this also you can write thinkers also. If Gandhi has done something and he was happy at that time, he was, even we got independence, but because of communal disturbances, Gandhi was not happy. So that shows that because of the contradictions, he was not happy. If we had a communal harmony, he would be happy. So those examples also you can connect. No, not much. But if you can think of anything, you can use it. If you think you can use it. Don't hesitate. I did test series, but again it was not very, it helped me, but okay. Thank you. Essay, I did not do anything. In first attempt I got 115 in 200, but I thought I can improve, so I went to a test series and my score dropped to 80. So after that I was very scared to touch upon essay, but I used to follow a simple framework. Essay should be simple, essay should be easy to read, and flow should be good. And you should use your current information, whatever you are reading. And simple thing is, have all the perspectives, sociological, psychological, legal, environment, political, combat related, whatever all the options are, you need to touch upon all those things. Then all other things you can do is cross-temporal analysis, cross-national analysis, interstate, interstate, okay, these are various aspects. You can make your list even bigger. You can think about what aspects can be there, and then fit your essay in that. What is the social aspect of that? What is the political aspect of that topic? What is the legal aspect? What is the environmental impact? What is the, how it is administration is affecting? Then how you can cross temporal analysis within India, before LPG, after LPG, before independence, after independence. If you have some points, you can make that. Similarly, cross national, how it is in developed world, developing world, how it is in US, how it is in China, if you know of something, or you can make some points which is logically reasonable, then you can do that. Similarly, if you know about south-north divide, any point is coming, you can touch that aspect. Similarly, within a state, western UP, eastern UP, western Maharashtra, eastern Maharashtra, if you are able to come up with something, and make your list even bigger, all the aspects that can be there in a. And then you are reading IDSA, you are reading IPCS, one or two articles, you are reading Yojana. That is your essay preparation. Your current is your essay preparation. Only thing is, you need to make a structure, spend some time of structure, and then write a free flowing essay connecting one paragraph to next paragraph. Then there are various tricks that they tell you to use in essay. I used in second attempt, I did not get a good mark, so after that I went to my natural self and write whatever I used to write. And quotation you can prepare 15, 20, 30, whatever newspaper is coming. If there is a quotation, use that. Indian Express, every day there is a quotation. You can, if it is relevant to some topic and you think you can remember, you can write that. On education, write 4-5 quotation. On social equality, write 4-4. On justice, Aristotle, all those quotation few you can remember. Other than that, what I used to do, some sloka I had remembered in English, in Hindi, in Sanskrit. That can be my starting point, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. If it is related to society, you can start from there. Then you can remember some poems like Into Father, My Father, what is Tagore poem. Those things you can remember, quotation you can remember, and use that information. And do use your current information. For example, this time I wrote essay on vision of India, that dream that does not let you sleep. In that, I, whenever I am touching upon education, I wrote what are the education policies, what are the, their development, how much they have progressed, what government is trying to do in improving that. Similarly, health, how the draft health policy has come, what aspect it is trying to touch. Skill, what are the government policies. After covering basic aspect, I am touching upon current affairs also. Write a decent introduction that you can write by using quotation, using slokas, or you can also use some incidents from newspaper. Make it little dramatic. For example, science is a boon or bane in 2014 or 13 it came. So I use that some person is there, he is having polio, so how science is helping him. So that you can build, make a story also 4, 5, 10 lines. And then every paragraph, how science has helped him. How science has helped him. That way I am connecting to that story also, and I am concluding based on that. These are few tricks that you can use. Moreover, other than that also, in newspaper every now and then you will see that Amar Sen in Argumentative India has said this. If you will read open ad page in Hindu, such type of information you will get there. So he has said something, I do not need to read Argumentative India. I will just copy that information. And if time permits or if there is a requirement, I will use that information. Similarly, you can get many information, anecdotes from various personalities also. Newspaper, you can get that. So you do not need to go separately. Other than that, there are booklets also on HA that gives that these information. But I think everybody uses that, so you need to be little careful. If you are coming up with your own, that will be more helpful. Anything else? So what I have done this time was value addition in all the papers, and how I can do that. And other than reading again and again, three things I did this time was revision, more and more number of revision. Every test I gave, I revised before that. Answer writing, almost every day, either GS or PABAD, I used to write answer. If I'm not writing answer, I used to make framework of that, one answer, two answer. Even if not in copy, in mental map also I used to do what I will write. It's very easy. Then test series, very seriously do that. I think it will help you. And if you have any queries in future, you can write me at. I hope it has been a little helpful. If you have any other questions, thank you, all the best.